Hello and welcome to the episode 69 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we have the end of a business relationship, a mysterious drum edit, and more work on getting better. On the 10th of March 1961, we record another three bookings in a day for the Beatles. The lads, with Pete Best on drums, had their third lunchtime gig at the Cavern Club in a week. Then, there was an evening engagement at the Grosvenor Ballroom in Wallasey, and finally, a concert at the St. John's Hall in Liverpool. The Grosvenor Ballroom gig was worth noticing because it was the last engagement negotiated for the band by Allan Williams. Williams had acted as a de facto manager for the band until then, despite the lack of any written agreement between the parts. The Beatles had reasons to be unhappy with him. For example, this was the only booking he had obtained for them in the 3 months since their return from Hamburg. That's one concert out of 74 total engagements the band negotiated for themselves through Pete and Mona Best during the same period of time. Despite the lack of a contract, the split between Williams and the Beatles might have had some bad consequences when their first proper manager, Brian Epstein, approached Williams while considering to take on the band in November 1961, but we will talk more about it in episode 305 of What a Fab Day. In 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, returned at the youth club of the St. Paul's Presbyterian Church in Birkenhead, 1 month after their last performance there. The Beatles headlined the show, supported by the Country Four with Brian Newman. The whole event took place between 7:30 and 11 p.m. Moving on to 1963, the Tommy Rowe and Chris Montez package tour reached the Hippodrome Theatre in Birmingham. The Beatles, after the success of the previous night, were promoted to the top position in the tour, closing the show on this and all the other performances. Talking about promotion, let me have a bit for myself. If you're liking this podcast, please visit www.simonmas.com/support to find out ways in which you can help me out. Please be fab and lend a hand. The more you'll help me, either with any donation or by simply spreading the word about this and my other music-related content, the more I will be able to concentrate on it, producing more and better free material for you all. Thank you! On the 10th of March 1964, the shootings for A Hard Day's Night continued today with one of the bits for the long solo sequence centered on Ringo Starr. The troupe shot the pub sequence today at the Turk's Head in Twickenham. Meanwhile, in Abbey Road, George Martin, aided by engineer Jeff Emerick, produced the stereo mixes for Can't Buy Me Love, Long Tall Sally, I Call Your Name, and You Can't Do That. In addition, there was a mono mixdown for Long Tall Sally, Come, Gib Mir Dein Hand, and Sie Liebt Dich. In 1991, the uncovering of an EMI document attested that an unknown drummer participated in the 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. session, recording some of the dubs to Can't Buy Me Love. This revealed why the stereo version of the song featured a slightly different drumming from the mono version. Just like it happened for the four Beatles, the mysterious session man was paid the musicians' union fee of £5.15, about £117 in 2020 money, for this session. For the Beatles, this money was in addition of any royalty received for the copyright ownership of any given song. In 1965, having completed the Bahamas shooting part for their second feature film, the Beatles left the island to return to London. Finally, in 1967, the Beatles put more work on getting better. Between 7 p.m. and 4 a.m., aided again by Malcolm Addey and Ken Townsend at the EMI Studios, they overdubbed a droning tambura played by George Harrison on track 4, a bass guitar played by Paul on track 3, and more snare and bass drums courtesy of Ringo on track 2 of the previous day's tape. This marks the end of another episode of What a Fab Day. Don't you miss the Big Beat session tomorrow. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.